A week ago, Craig and Gavin were given a shabby fairground waltzer with corroded metal and rotting upholstery. Drew wanted to retain the artwork on the outside, but gave the pair permission to do what they like on the inside. And they hope they've not disappointed. Outrageously reupholstering it in crushed velvet, there's a luxury footstool and even built-in lighting that might have once met with approval from the original artist himself, futuristic Fred Fowle. But what will Drew say to the fabulous reframing?
He's either going to like it or hate it, but I quite like it. I'd have it in my house.
It's a statement piece.
Yeah, yeah, we're not allowed to do it again.
Yeah.
We both had our own ideas what to do with the waltzer. Loads of ideas came in and out, but we came up with this in the end and we're both quite happy with it.
We've pushed it to the limit. We've gone as far as we could go with it. It's not Drew's sort of thing to start with, so I'm hoping he will like it.
And if the glitzy upholstery and bright lights weren't enough, Craig and Gavin have hatched another surprise for Drew, hidden inside the footstool.
Fantastic. Are you pleased with yourself, you pair?
Yeah.
We are, but it's you.
Honestly?
Yeah. Yeah, honestly.
I think it looks brilliant. I think it looks great. There's only one way to go with that, which was just full bore, full on, and that is, you've done it. The waltzer, what can I tell you? It needed to be crazy. I gave the lads free rein on it, and they've pulled it out of the bag, and I think it's great. What's all that about at the front there? What's that thing?
You might need that. Just come over here.
What do I hit?
Just press those buttons there.
Oh, you're kidding me. Are you kidding? Oh, my life. Somebody's going to love this. Does it close?
Press the button again.
Never know what it was
there. That's a wonderful. It's a wonderful.
Oh, at least it made you smile.
It's made me smile. I think it's great. I really do. I don't know whether I have it in my own house, but I'll tell you what, it's saleable. Because the sort of person who wants that, an extrovert, somebody larger than life, who wants a waltzer and an original Fred Fowle painted waltzer, will want that purple and silver crushed velvet with a telly that comes out of it. And why not?
The very first Louis Vuitton trunks, dating from the late 1850s, were light grey, soon followed by designs in beige and brown.
Look carefully, you can see the light brown canvas coming through. There we go, that is the original colour.
As this canvas layer is non-original, Martin's removing it to replace it with a colour more in keeping with when it was first built.
It looks a complete and utter mess now, but you wait for the magic to start. I'll clean the woodwork with wire wool and white spirit. It'll just take off any surface soil that it's gathered over the years. This was made in the days of coal fires, days of steam travel. So consequently, any handling that it had by porters and people was always absolutely manky.
Having stripped the cracked and peeling canvas covering, Martin has to give the trunk an authentic new outer skin. He's tracked down a modern-day fabric very close to that used by the original Louis Vuitton craftsman.
I managed to do a bit of digging, talking to people who deal in Louis Vuitton, and we came up with this material, what they call a legal buckram.
Hard-wearing buckram is made of stiff cotton and used to bind legal reference books.
It is exactly the same thickness, the same weight, the same weave, virtually the same colour as what Louis Vuitton used on their cases. So out of nothing, we've come up with a perfect replica.
It's glued on with carpet adhesive, and Martin uses a time-tested tool to achieve perfectly fitted edges.
This is what I call a bone folder. It's made of antler, which is in effect bone. It's ideal, it's smooth, it gets right into the corners I need to crease it. But it's a piece of antler that was picked up in Scotland and you can get right into the edges, so I know where to cut. Now that is slightly different.
After 2 weeks in Martin's workshop, this trunk is once again ready for adventure, with an elegantly aged fabric covering and lining and retaining all the original studs and frame. Martin's even added vintage luggage labels, and the trunk is now valued at up to £3,000.
That's amazing. How have you done that?
This cloth is all new. I stripped the whole orange thing out. Kidding. This material, it's virtually the same thing the Louis Vuitton would cover their cases in the early days.
Wow. Well, there's a few things I need to ask you about it, because obviously my concern was, see these nail heads?
They're all the original.
Did you take them out?
Not all of them.
Not all of them.
The ones I took out, they all went back intact. The only things that is different are the straps itself.
I'm staggered.
And I'm amazed. And the outside. Man of many talents,
look
you
at
see.
That! That is absolutely fantastic.
The Mouseman furniture from Shilston House has gone to French polisher Alex. The stools only need a rub down and wax, but the marks on the desk that Drew was worried about are going to call for some industrial strength paint stripper.
What I've always liked about working on Mouseman furniture is the texture of it. This texture that you see on the top is all over every piece. You feel it on every stretcher, on every panel.
The distinctive rippled surface is achieved using a specialist tool called an adze, and it's all done by hand.
It's just such a nice texture to work with. As you're rubbing it and polishing it, you can feel those little ripples all the way down that have been painstakingly put into the piece. Paint stripper's done a great job. It's cleaned it up straight away, really, and it's taken off a lot of the dirt. We've still got a slight ring mark left, but to be honest, we're better living with a ring mark than taking anything away from the original Mouseman finish.
With the years of grime removed, the desk is coated in a dark oak wax, revealing the ripples the maker is famous for.
Well, that has gone absolutely perfect. The colour is spot on, looks original Mouseman all day long, and it's got a lovely soft sheen to it. It just catches the detail of that ripple top that you get in a Mouseman, and it looks original, so I'm delighted with that.